And a cylinder, a piston cylinder device, initially it contains 0.4 meter cubic initially of air and 100 kilopascal and 80 centigrade. The air now is compressed to the 0.1 meter cubic in a such way that the temperature inside the cylinder remains constant. Temperature remains the constant. Determine the work done by during the process. Okay. In the situation, temperature is constant at the initially, volume is 0.4 meter cubic, pressure is the 100 kilopascal, and the temperature is constant 80 centigrade. And for PV diagram, you said that this is the at the initially. This is the first one, and we compressed this one. Okay, this is the initial value, and this is the second value. And what about the boundary work here? In boundary work, we have to know that PdV, as you see here. First of all, we have the also we have to determine that the what is pressure. But this one here, 100 kilopascal and 80 degrees. And in this situation, we assume that this air is a ideal gas. Okay, this is the pressure is small or pressure is low. And the as you remember that the if the pressure is low, all the gas is behave like a ideal gas, but in our definition, under the 10 kilopascal pressure, the ideal gas is defined behave like a ideal gas regardless of the temperature, irrespective of the temperature. But in this situation, our pressure is low, not so much. Therefore, we said that this is the we assume that is an ideal gas. Okay, in ideal gas, PV is changing MR. This is because of the volume, not specific volume. Therefore, we write the pressure volume is equal to mass, gas constant, and the temperature. And in this situation, we said that this is the PV MR T0 is C. Or we said that the pressure is equal to C divided by volume. Okay. Now we have to make pressure work, boundary work. Boundary work is calculated integral P, differential volume, integral from one state to two states. Now P is C divided by volume and make integral with differential volume. And C is, of course, constant because of the ideal, for ideal gas C is constant. Therefore, one and two differential volume divided by the volume. What about the integral of this one? You have known this.
Ln.
Okay, ln C, ln because of the ln. Maybe we can write here ln volume to volume two to volume one. Therefore, we write here C ln volume two divided by the volume one. And for C, what about C? C is P multiple one. Of course, C is the MR T0. Therefore, they are right here. C is the constant. If the C is constant, P volume P1 is equal also like this. P pressure 1 volume 1 is equal to P2 volume 2. We can write also P2 volume 2 is pressure 1, pressure 2 and volume 2. It can be right here instead of pressure 1 and volume 2. But in this situation, I choose the pressure 1 and volume 1 ln volume 2 divided by the volume 1. And let me calculate the pressure, boundary work here, because it gives the initial pressure and initial volume here, but they don't give the what about pressure. But they said that the temperature remains constant, pressure not remains constant. Therefore, we know the pressure one and volume one, but in the situation, we don't know what is pressure, but we know the volume. But in the situation, I write the pressure one and the volume one here, because we know this value from the initial. And 100 kilopascal pressure and volume is the 0.4 meter cubic, and ln volume 2 is the 0. In this situation, ln 2 is 0.1 to 0.4 meter cubic, and in this situation, our boundary work is minus 55.45 kilojoule. And why is the minus? Because of the compression, and compression is the work is, boundary work is the minus, therefore the kilojoule is 55.45 kilojoule. Okay, it's also a good example. And we looked at what is polytropic, isothermal, and isobaric process. Okay, for polytropic process, pressure is changed with like this. Pressure is changed C, volume power of minus N. This is the C and this is the N polytropic exponent. This is the constant. And what about C? C is the, as you remember in the problem, P and pressure multiple volume. Okay. And in this situation, this is the polytropic process. Polytropic process obeys this rule, obeys the pressure is changing like this. C, velocity power of the minus N. N is the polytropic exponent. Okay, this is the constant. And what about the boundary works? Boundary work is, you know, this formulation from 1 to 2, P, pressure differential volume, make an integral of it. And pressure is, as you see, C minus 1, C, velocity 10 to the power minus N, and dy. And for the situation, C is, and we make the differential. What about this differential? As you maybe I can write here, C is constant. We make the out of the integral. What about this integral? Do you know what is this integral? Pardon. This integral. This integral is like this as far as I remember. We make and plus the from one situation to two situation. Okay, from two to one. We put the plus one to exponential, the one volume to power minus n plus one divided by the n plus one. This is also minus n plus one. Okay, this is the rule of the integral. Therefore, you see the integral rule and write the volume to power of the minus n plus 1 minus volume 1 to power of the minus n plus 1 divided by the minus n plus 1. Okay, what about the C? C is C, P minus P and volume. Okay, pressure and volume. In this situation, also we can set that pressure 2 and volume 2 minus pressure volume 1. Also, we can write like this, maybe it is the polytropic process. C minus volume 2 minus n and plus, and it gives the pressure 2 and volume 2 minus pressure 1 to volume 1 divided by 1 minus n. This is the polytropic process. In polytropic process, the boundary work is calculated like this. Okay. Again, for polytropic and ideal gas, maybe I can explain like this. And for polytropic and for ideal gas, it's the polytropic process. And for ideal gas, there is n is not equal to 1. This is the inequilibrium condition. N is not equal to 1. For ideal gas, as you remember, the what about the ideal gas? P volume m r t, as you remember. And for the situation P2 and pressure 2 and volume 2 and minus pressure 1 to volume 1 is equal to mR in the situation, for example, T is changing, mR T2 minus temperature 2 minus T1 and divided by the 1 minus N. For polytropic and for ideal gas, the boundary work is defined like this, okay? And what about the for N1? For N1 is the isothermal process. Isothermal means thermal is not changing here. Isothermal process, and all temperature is not changing here. And for the situation, for N1, boundary work is from 1 to 2 pressure and differential volume of we make of integral, and C minus this the N is the 1 as you see is, and for isothermal process minus 1 dV. Therefore our integral is the P pressure and volume and ln volume 2 divided by the volume 1 for isothermal process. Okay, for isothermal process, N is 1. This N is 1. This is the polytropic, but polytropic constant is 1. Therefore, this is the isothermal process. And this one is the boundary work of isothermal process. And what about the constant pressure process? Constant pressure process. In the situation, the pressure is constant. Therefore, we extract the pressure out of the integral. And P0, and it means the dy, d volume, differential volume. After that, the pressure 1 and the volume is changing from state 1 to state 2. This is the constant pressure process of the moving boundary work. Okay. Now we look to three or four boundary works. First one is the polytropic process. Polytropic process obeys this rule. And for this rule, polytropic process, boundary work of the polytropic process is defined pressure to multiple volume 2 minus pressure 1 volume 1 divided by 1 minus n. And for polytropic and ideal gas, for ideal gas, the pressure is changing with mRTn, changing with mass, gas constant, and temperature. Therefore, we said that mass, gas constant, T2, temperature 2, and minus temperature 1, divided by 1 minus n. For, again, polytropic process, but the polytropic exponent is n. If the polytropic exponent is n, in this situation, the polytropic process, we can say the isothermal process. In isothermal process, temperature is changing because iso means the constant, thermal is the temperature, constant temperature process. And in this situation, boundary work is PV ln, pressure volume, and ln volume state 2 and volume state 1. and for constant pressure is constant, therefore we extract from the integral, and the volume is changing, and pressure is, and volume 2 minus volume 1. Okay. Now, for this information, we solve the problem. This is the good problem also. Example 4-4. Okay. In this situation, a piston cylinder device contains at the beginning 0.05 meter cubic of volume of a gas initially at 200 kilopascal. Okay, at the beginning 200 kilopascal is the pressure and volume is the 0.05 meter cubic. At this state, a linear spring that has a spring constant K 150 kilonewton divided by meter is touching the piston. Okay, first at the initial one, after that the spring touches the piston, but not exerting no force on it. Therefore, there is no force. Okay. Now heat is transferred to the gas into the cylinder, causing the piston to rise. Piston is expansion and compressed spring. Okay, for heating, entering the heating the cylinder, piston goes to this system is makes expansion. Of course, the spring is making compression. Okay, and causing the piston to the rise and the compressed spring until the volume inside the doubles. It means that volume is make double. Okay, maybe we can set here volume 2 is 0.1 meter cubic. Okay. And if the cross-sectional area is area of the piston is 0.25 meter square, and determine the final pressure inside the cylinder. First, final pressure inside the cylinder. After that, total work done by the gas and friction of this work done against the spring to compress it. Okay. Again, we solve. First of all, our volume is make double. It means we multiply the first volume and we get the second state volume. And our volume is this one. And what about, firstly, what we calculate the in what this X, what is the expansion of piston and cylinder mechanism, and what is the compression of the spring? First of all, we have to define that. And this X is delta volume changing divided by area. And the volume changing is, the second one is 0.2 and the first one is 0.05. Also, it says that it makes double, and the difference between of the, again, the 0.05. Okay. And the area of the piston is 0.25 meter square, and the X is 0.2 meter. Okay. The piston expansion in X and the spring is compression with X. Okay, now we find what is expansion length of the piston, or what is compression length of the spring. Okay, and in this situation, the force applied by the spring at the final state. In the spring work, as you remember, spring work, the spring constant multiple x, because of the they said that the linear spring. Okay, I am so sorry, I have to talk. Okay, alo, evet, dersteyim ben şeyde. Okay. Now, the first applied by the linear spring at the final state. Okay. At the final state, state two, the force is calculate because of the spring. This is the linear spring, and the force is, pardon, the force is calculate the, in the linear formulation Kx, and the K is 150 kilonewton divided by meter, and the X is, as we determined or we calculated before, 0.2 meter. Therefore, the force is 30 kilonewton. Okay. Now, what about the applied pressure? Because of the, what is to say, the final pressure inside of the cylinder. The applied pressure speak is in the gas at this state, at the final state. The pressure is F divided by N, and we look the spring force 30 kilonewton, and the area is the 0.25 meters square, and therefore our this spring affects the, at the final spring affects the pressure at the final state is 120 kilopascal. But in this situation, gas as initially in the gas, there is the initially at 200 kilopascal. Therefore, the total pressure of at the final stage, this is the, is the initially, after that the, is the compression, but expansion, but in the expansion, pressure is maybe not changing, or maybe pressure is decreasing. But in this state, the force, the linear spring force, the our piston, and this, we found the force here or pressure here, and our total pressure is 320 kilopascal. Okay, our the final pressure. What about the, they ask that the total work done by gas. Okay, it means boundary work, after that friction of the this work. Okay, and what about the easy hand? Okay, I forget the total work by done by the gas. Okay, the gas is overcome the this spring, of course, again, as you remember. Okay, maybe I can write this, calculate like this also. This is so important. There is no area of it. Okay, me like this. They said that total, first of all, total work done by the gas, because gas at the initially is here, after that make a boundary work expansion, but at the same time the boundary work overcome the springs. Okay, the springs force. Therefore, the total work is calculated like this: for one state at the initial one, the other state like this. The kilopascal, the total pressure is the 320 kilopascal. Initial pressure is 200 kilopascal. Volume is the initial like this, and after that the volume is doubled, as you remember. And we calculate the total work. Total work, what about the in PV diagram? The total work is calculated is the area of under the, this line. Therefore, the total work is calculated like this. For one, maybe I write here, for one, volume and pressure. Pressure is the 200, and the volume is like this, 0.05. And what about the first area one? 10, it's 2, 10, 200 multiple, 0.05. It is 10, I think, eh? And what about 2? 4, pardon. What about 2? Okay, this is 10. And what about 2? And this is the triangular, and we make the length at this one, and we make divide by 3. This one minus this multiple 0.05 divided by 2, and this is maybe I can calculate like this. First I calculate the first one, pardon, this is the 200 multiple 10, true. And this one I calculate the second one, 120, 320 minus 200, 120 multiple 0.05 divided by 2, and it's 3, of course, and this is 3. Okay. This is 3. Therefore, total work of is 10 plus 3. This is the 13 kilojoule. Okay. And the area of the easy way to find the work done by the plot of the process on PV diagram and find the area of the under the process curve. Therefore, we calculate the area and we find the 13 kilojoule. Okay. And what about the last question? The fraction of this work done against the spring to compress it. Okay. And what about the spring? Spring work is calculated like this. 1 divided by 2 K second state length square and first state length square minus between them. Okay. Or maybe we can calculate like this again. This is similar to like this. This is the spring work, as you remember, because this is the spring. This is spring force, and the spring work is like this. But in this situation, the spring work calculated like this. Again, the same area, the area of 2, and we calculate the area of 2 is the 3, because of this, that the fraction of this work done against the spring to compress it, because spring for compress the spring against this fraction, the spring fraction, and we calculate the area of the area 2, we calculate the area 2, therefore, this is the spring is the 3 kilojoule, and we calculate before. And this problem is good for understanding the expansion of the cylinder and compression of the spring. And you calculate the what about the spring? Okay, you have find the 3 kilojoule. Okay, you have to find the same value. Now we have 9 minutes. Okay, I have to explain what about the energy balance for the closed systems. Now for closed systems, this is the energy balance. It means that thermodynamic first law of the closed system. Also the basic definition of the thermodynamic first law is the what about this for closed system. Energy inlet minus energy outlet is changing delta energy system. Net energy transfer by heat, work and mass, the net energy transfer is equal to change in internal kinetic and potential energy. You know that the energy system is changing with delta L kinetic energy, delta potential energy, and delta internal energy. Okay. And in this situation, our unit is kilojoule. But what about in this situation, we choose the time step size. In this situation, the energy conserved with this delta T, with this time. But if we choose that, if the energy is conserved for all time, therefore we write the energy inlet dot minus energy outlet dot. It means that rate of net energy transfer by heat work and mass. In this situation, our unit is watt. And in this situation, energy inlet dot minus energy outlet dot is equal to delta energy system changing with time. Rate of change of internal energy, kinetic energy and the potential energy. Okay, this is the energy balance in rate form. And this is the energy balance of kilojoule form, we can say energy balance of watt form. Okay, this is the rate form. And the total quantities are related to quantities per unit time. Again, this is the, also this is the per unit time, this is the watt, and this is the not per unit time. And this is the Q, kilojoule. Okay, we can write like here, Q divided by delta T, because this is the kilojoule. Okay, this is the second, and it means Q dot rate form of the heat is watt. In this situation, they write here, Q is equal to Q dot multiple dT. This is the delta T, okay. Q is Q dot multiple delta T. The same, in the same manner, work is equal to work dot multiple dT. And what about the energies? Delta energy is equal to delta energy changing multiple delta T. Okay, this quantities are related to per unit time. And this is the kilojoule. This is the kilojoule. This is the kilowatt. And this is the second. Okay. And what about the energy balance per unit mass? Okay. Energy inlet, energy outlet is equal to delta energy system. In this situation, this formulation is kilojoule divided by kilogram. Okay. And we write the energy balance of differential form. Delta energy inlet is equal to delta energy outlet is changing delta energy system. Okay, in this situation, differential form, but in this situation, our unit is kilojoule. And energy balance of differential form, but also the per unit mass basis. Okay, delta small a inlet minus delta small a outlet is equal to delta small a, small e, pardon, not small a system. Is equal to the unit is the kilojoule divided by kilogram. And for a cycle, maybe there is a cycle here. Okay, for a cycle, Q net out is V net in. I mean that because of the in energy cycle, energy comes like this, energy the state. For example, state one, state two, from one to two, again, it comes from one, two to one. You said that the net energy is equal to Q net. We can say the heat transfer is equal to, net heat transfer is equal to net work, okay? Therefore, for example, we said that the internal energy inlet is equal to energy inlet minus energy outlet is equal to delta A system. Okay. In the situation, we said that Q net in, for example, the heat is entering here, Q net in minus V naught W net out is equal to delta A system. Of we write that as a simple one, Q minus W is equal to delta A. Okay. And for Q net in and when, also we said that what is Q net and what is W net, Q is V, Q net is Q in minus Q out. W net is W out minus W in. Okay. Because this is the heat input and work output is positive for heat input are positive and work output are positive. Therefore, we write here is a sine rule and heat put and work input are negative. Okay. And this is the general form is a summary. The general one is a for cycle. Q and Q minus W is a delta A. For stationary system, there is no velocity in system. There is no moving of system. Therefore, they said that the Q also the delta A is contains delta kinetic energy plus delta potential energy and plus delta internal energy. Therefore, in stationary system, for kinetic, there is no velocity or there is no moving here. Therefore, kinetic energy is zero. And we said that there is no difference length, highness, height difference between the system, state one and state two. Therefore, we said that in stationary system, Q minus W is del U. Internal energy changing, and for per unit mass, Q minus small Q minus small W is changing delta small E. Okay, per unit mass kilojoule divided by kilogram. In this situation, kilojoule. Kilojoule divided by kilogram. And for differential form, because delta canonical delta V is because of the PET functions, delta Q minus delta W is equal to delta internal energy. Okay. Now we have the 1 minute, therefore we cannot solve this problem, but next week we solve this problem, and this problem is so important, maybe repeat of the energy balance for closed system. After that, we solve this problem and we continue. Okay.